For our lecture three quiz review, let's go over what's going to be on the questions. So one of the first questions you'll have is on just the basic properties of an atom. And yes, this is elementary, but there are certain things that in the future, when we discuss them in class, that you need to know, certain basic terminology, which is why I do one question on lecture three regarding the basic structure of an atom. Because when I talk about isotopes, when I talk about protons and neutrons, when we get into energy, when we get into electrons, electron flow, you really have to make sure you know how this stuff works to be able to understand those higher concepts. So yes, it may seem elementary. Yeah, this is an atom. I have several questions on the quiz, but you only have one, but I have groupings of several questions. So some of the questions may ask what gives an atom its mass, in which case it would be the neutrons and the protons. If I ask you what gives an atom its properties, as we've discussed, that's the protons. The number of protons determines the element. You add a proton, you get a new element. You add another proton, you get a new element. And that's because, as we've discussed, every time you add a proton, then an electron will naturally surround the atom as part of its properties, and that determines how the atom's going to interact with other atoms. Okay? So the mass is the combination of the protons and neutrons. The properties of the atom is the protons. And another question you may get is on isotopes. Remember, isotopes are atoms that have the same number of protons but different number of neutrons, like carbon-14. Carbon-14 has 6 protons and 8 neutrons. So you need to know the term isotopes. You need to know some of those other things I just told you about for that question. Now, as far as valence electron shell theory, everyone's going to get a question on valence electron shell theory. So make sure you understand what that is all about from the lecture. You're also going to get a couple of questions on how it applies, meaning one question will be, I'll give you an atom, I'll tell you the number of protons and neutrons, just like you're seeing here, and I'll ask you how it fills up the valence electron shells. Remember the rules. 2 in the first shell, 8 in the second, 8 in the third. They always fill up the first shell first, and then the second, and then whatever's left over if there's more, and all that. Don't be distracted by the neutrons. There are some false questions out there meant to distract you based upon the number of neutrons. Remember, the number of protons determines how many electrons surround the atom's nucleus. A second question, you will have to refer back to the periodic table. And this comes down to these numbers up here, the 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how many protons are in the atom. That's also how many electrons are surrounding it. And so I'll give you the atom, its name, its shorthand, because sometimes it doesn't make sense, like sodium is Na, and they don't fit, so I'll give you both. And then I'll say how many electrons are in the outermost valence shell, right? So if we were taking sodium here, which has 11 protons, it would have 11 electrons, 2 in the first shell, 8 in the second, with 1 more in the third. So the answer would be 1, and you would look for that. So I can use any of these elements in the first 3 rows for that question. So you will need to refer back to this PowerPoint periodic table for that question as well. Now, all the rest of the questions you're going to have for exam or for quiz 3 is on these 3 bonds right here. And some of them are just definitions, some of them are application. So make sure you know the difference between an ionic bond, a covalent bond, and a hydrogen bond. But there's some other questions here or there. For example, on this one, on covalent bonds, make sure you know that the more covalent bonds a molecule has, the more energy that molecule has. This is going to be an important concept as we move forward, is that the larger the molecule, meaning more covalent bonds, is more energy. So again, of these 4, caffeine has the most energy because it has the most covalent bonds, right? And then when we get into organic molecules, you're going to see the same concept. Also, you will be able to have to distinguish between polar covalent bonds and just covalent bonds, or what we call nonpolar covalent bonds, but sometimes we just say covalent bonds. For example, water is a polar covalent bond because the electrons have a stronger affinity for oxygen than they do for hydrogen, and so it creates a polarity on the molecule. And as we discuss, that polarity ultimately is what results in the hydrogen bond. So make sure you understand and define what a hydrogen bond is. It's the weak attraction between opposite polarities, between the positive polarity and the negative polarity on a molecule. Now, this doesn't just apply to water. Make sure you also know it applies to DNA and to proteins. We're going to get into these organic molecules later, but DNA gets its structure, its double helix, because of hydrogen bonding. Proteins fold because of hydrogen bonding, kind of like origami. Water has its properties because of hydrogen bonding. These are examples that I'll use for hydrogen bonds on the quiz as well. Okay, so make sure you know that hydrogen bond doesn't hold the covalent bond structure of DNA together. That's this part right here. These bonds right there between the phosphates, sugars, and bases and all of that. Those are covalent bonds. But what hydrogen bond does do for DNA is it gives it this double helix structure. Covalent bonds hold the amino acids together in these chains that we're going to discuss later, but hydrogen bonding allows for these chains to fold into that protein structure, which is what gives it its function. So covalent bond is the energy, and it's what holds molecules together in their rigid, shape, but hydrogen bond is what gives the molecules their properties. It's what gives water its properties, DNA its structure, protein its folding, and all of that. You will not have any questions on electronegativity. This was just designed to teach you how some atoms have a stronger pull on electrons than others, but do make sure you know the difference between nonpolar and polar covalent bonds for the quiz.